What's up guys, Chris O'Shea here back with another video today. And today's video is another CDL home series bracket prediction, this time for the Toronto home series that will take place this upcoming weekend. I would first like to say that I'm sorry for not coming out with a prediction last event for CDL London. It was a very crazy week for me last week and I ended up not having time to make it before the event. I would also like to give my congratulations to the New York Subliners for winning the last event I made a bracket prediction for, and to the Dallas Empire on winning the latest event, which was the London home series as I said before. This upcoming event, the Toronto home series, will be an absolute bloodbath. All the top 4 teams are in this event and it's the last push for everyone before champ. Dallas, if they won this event, can secure the 1 seed, and all the other teams are looking to secure a best as a position as they can to Sanx before the season concludes. Alright, but that's pretty much it for me in this video. As always, leave a like if you enjoyed, subscribe if you're new, and comment below what your thoughts are. I would love to hear what you think of my bracket and love to hear how you guys think this event will turn out as well. Alright, but that's pretty much all I have for now, and I hope you guys enjoy. Alright, ladies and gentlemen, here we are, the last bracket before CDL champs this year, the first ever franchising in the Call of Duty League. We're here with the CDL Toronto home series bracket, and let's just get things going here. First matchup here, the Chicago Huntsmen versus Seattle Surge. Surge, it's a tragic story, I'm sure most of you know. Octane, one of the best players in the game. Karma, one of the GOATs, retired midseason. Apathy is pissed. Everyone on Surge is having a tough time. There's fines being given to Surge left and right. They haven't been able to play in team scrims. They're being scummed by the league. Like, it's just not their year. Very unfortunate scenes for the Seattle Surge. I really wanted Surge to do good this year too, which is why it's so tragic. But because of this, I will have to give this one to the Chicago Huntsmen boys. 3-2-1. Next up, Toronto Ultra versus Optic Gaming. Here we sit. Toronto Ultra have been looking good recently. It is their event as well. Teams where it has been their event have been looking better as of late. It looks like both teams made the Championship Sunday recently, being London and New York. New York going on to win, but that has only happened twice on the year. Optic, on the other hand, has looked better and is starting to look worse, I would say, again, but they're still looking better than they did at the beginning of the season. But they also have Draza and Hollow, their new additions to the team, making it so they're kind of on the bubble. No one really knows how they're going to turn out, but I do think that Optic will be able to pull this one out. But I do think it will be close series here, which is why I will go 3-2 in favor of LA Optic. Next up here in round one, we have Atlanta FaZe versus the Minnesota Rocker. Minnesota Rocker looked like a top tier team very early on when it was on LAN, have slowly been on the decline the remainder of the season online. Unfortunate for them. They're still a very good team, but FaZe, on the other hand, has been that top tier team all season, still one in the standings, multiple event wins. A favorite by many to win champs, I'm sure, but I think this is going to be a good series as well. Minnesota has not disappointed really that much this season, and they've been a solid team, but I still think it will go to the boys at Atlanta FaZe, which is why I will call this one also 3-2 in favor of Atlanta FaZe. Last matchup here, another T4 team matchup in round one, the Florida Mutineers versus the Dallas Empire. Dallas coming off an event win. Florida, the only team with back-to-back event wins this season. It's heating up here. Last push before champs. This is an insane matchup for round one. Both talented teams. Both teams can easily win champs here. This is a very hard series to call. Dallas is the current hot team, though, and I do think they are looking better with the new meta. Florida is still a very fantastic team, but Clan Krim with this new meta, I think, is benefiting them. Shots and Illy have been insane all season, which is why I think this one I'm going to have to give to the Dallas Empire in a 3-2 fashion. Next up here, knockout round one, the first losers game of CDL Toronto, or the Toronto Ultra home series, and the last event before champs here. These are some last teams games before champs that they will play at all. Seattle Surge and Toronto Ultra, for one of you it will be your last game here. But this one, once again, the Seattle Surge, they've just been a disappointing team to say the least all season long. It has not been great for them so far, and Toronto Ultra have been looking even better recently, which is why I'm unfortunately gonna have to end the Seattle Surge's time in the CDL except for champs here and advance Toronto in a 3-2-1 fashion once again. I'm sorry, Seattle. Octane, I'll pour one out for you, my guy. Next up here, knockout round one, the Minnesota Rocker versus the Florida Mutineers. Both teams have been very good all season long. Florida more so than Minnesota, but Minnesota has been one of those teams on the upper bubble, I would say, all season. They have been on the upper half of the standings and they've been performing well. They just have not pulled out an event win quite yet, But Florida, on the other hand, they do believe they're still going to be hungry, as it is right before champs. They're no longer on top of the game, I would say. They still are definitely a top contender, but they did lose last event. They were there. They have to prove themselves somewhat that they are still in a position to be considered the best team in this game when this game ends, versus the Minnesota Rocker are still looking for that one event when they can't just quite close the door. But I think Florida will be able to close the door on them. And I'm sorry, Minnesota, but I think your tournament will be ending here as well. I do think it'll be a close series though, which is why I'll give this one 3-2 in favor of Florida Mutineers. Quarterfinals matchup one, Chicago Huntsman versus LA Optic. You could say the real Optic versus the fake Optic, the new Optic versus the old Optic. Clearly, you got Skump and Formal here with Chicago Huntsman. Hex is now helping with Huntsman versus the new Optic, I guess you would say, which is not really owned by Optic. If you know the league, you know what I'm talking about there. But this could be an exciting matchup to watch. And you know, on the other hand, you have Slasher and Kenny, the new boys. But it should be an interesting matchup to watch. You have the Twins, T2P, Envoy, and Skump versus Slasher, Kenny, and all of them over there at Optic. But I do think this one will definitely be going in favor of the Chicago Huntsman, which is why I will have to send them into Championship Sunday 3-2-1 over LA Optic and send LA Optic to play Toronto. The other quarterfinals matchup here, Atlanta FaZe versus the Dallas Empire, coming from the by far tougher side of the bracket here. Both teams, Atlanta, Minnesota, Florida, and Dallas, neither team really has caught a break this event so far with their matchups, and they're not catching a break here either. Another T4 matchup. That means that Dallas will be going straight into two T4 matchups just to try to advance throughout this bracket and make it as far as they can. But once again, another crazy matchup here. But this one, I do honestly think that this may go in favor of the Dallas Empire over Atlanta FaZe, even though FaZe was the best team in the game for a while, still debatably is. I do think this new meta has really helped Clay and Krim, as it is an AR heavy meta versus FaZe on the other hand, which is still a very strong team. BZ has looked amazing with the new MP5, do not get me wrong, but I do think this new meta may just be a little bit much for them to handle. But I do think it'll be a very close series, which is why I will call this one 3-2 in favor of the Dallas Empire over Atlanta FaZe, sending them on to Championship Sunday. Next up here in knockout round two for a spot in Championship Sunday, we have LA Optic facing the Toronto Ultra here. I think Toronto has been looking good as of late. Kleenex has been a great addition to the team. Cammy look great. And I do think this team will be able to continue the trend, especially right before champs, of wanting to continue these runs for these teams, pushing and making it seem like they can compete with the best, which is why I honestly do think this one will be going in favor of the Toronto Ultra once again in a 3-2 fashion, because I do not think they will be able to take LA Optic twice. But they have been looking a lot better as of recently, and this is a team that could easily do some damage, especially right before champs with that motivation and with them being their own event, which is why I have them advancing on to Championship Sunday along with Huntsman and the Dallas Empire. Now the last matchup here in knockout round two, another T4 matchup here, Atlanta FaZe versus the Florida Mutineers. Both teams have had a very tough event. Like I've said, this entire side of the bracket is just stacked. And now here we are, another T4 matchup, now putting one team out of competition until champs, which is crazy to me to think about right now. But I do think this will also be a very good matchup. FaZe, they've been a little bit of a slump. They've still been a top team, but a little bit of a slump recently. Have not quite been able to get back on top and secure anything. Florida also not really on a slump, but more so as they did not secure the last event win. Clearly, Dallas Empire did. They were able to take them on. They were able to just, Dallas looked absolutely lights out last event. Props to them, truly. But this is another really good matchup here. Two teams that could both very easily take champs. But I do honestly think this time that this one will be going in favor of Atlanta FaZe. I do think FaZe is hungry to get back on top more so than Florida. Florida has been a great team, but they did win back-to-back. They still are on top. Both teams are still on top, do not get me wrong. I think both teams are going to be hungry. It's a really hard series to call. They could really go either way. Both teams really want to secure this event win and put themselves in the position to be the team that wins the event right before champs. But I do think this one will go to the hands of Atlanta FaZe in a 3-2 fashion, and they will be advancing on to complete our Championship Sunday here at the Toronto Home Series. Now here we sit, the last four teams standing before champs, CDL champs, the first ever champs of franchising. Chicago Huntsman, Atlanta FaZe, Dallas Empire, and Toronto Ultra. Here we go. First matchup here, Chicago Huntsman versus Atlanta FaZe. Last time these two teams met, They also met in the semifinals. These teams have not yet competed in a grand final, even though they were 1-2 on the standings for pretty much the entirety of the season. This may not be the case anymore, but these two teams are still definitely both forces to be reckoned with. And I do think this series will hopefully be closer, as last time these two teams met, anyone that watches knows, Chicago played absolutely lights out, which is something you absolutely love to see. You love to see Chicago was playing like that, but I'm sure everyone wanted this series to be competitive. But based on that, I'm going to have to give this series to the Chicago Huntsmen, but I do not think FaZe will quite slide as hard this time. I do think they will give Huntsmen a run for their money, and I'm thinking the series will be closer this time, especially right before champs, which is why I'm calling this one 3-2 in favor of the Chicago Huntsmen, sending them on to another grand finals for their second event in a row. And the final matchup here before grand finals of the Toronto home series, Dallas Empire versus Toronto Ultra. Toronto Ultra, they've been on the lower half of the standings all season long, but this is their event. They have been looking good as of late, and I do expect them to step up to the plate and be able to advance here and get themselves on to Sunday. Dallas Empire, on the other hand, coming straight off an event when beating some of the best teams in the game to do it. I fully expect them to be coming out and gunning, especially right before champs too. I think they will still be hungry, and which is why I have them here. But this matchup right here, I'm going to have to give this to the Dallas Empire here. They've just been looked absolutely dominant as of last weekend with this new meta. This team has looked insane. They just stomped everyone. I do not think it will be quite this bad though, but I do not think it will be a very close series either, which is why I will give this one 3-1 in favor of the Dallas Empire, setting them on two grand finals of the Toronto home series to face the Chicago ones. All right, ladies and gentlemen, here we are, our last grand finals prediction before the CDL championships, which will be coming up here momentarily. The Chicago Huntsmen versus the Dallas Empire. All of your top four teams were at this event. This is who I predicted to make it out on top: Chicago versus Dallas. Dallas coming straight off an event win, Chicago with an event win very recently as well, and also making it to grand finals very recently, last losing there to the New York Subliners. Of course, both teams have been looking very strong on this new meta, and I expect both teams to really come out gunning this last event here before champs. But unfortunately, I'm going to have to call the last game before CDL champs in favor of the Dallas Empire. This team has just looked too dominant on this new meta. They have been stomping everyone. I believe they've dropped one map total since this new meta shift, and I just expect them to continue this tear that they're on. I know Krim's hungry, Clay's hungry. This whole team is just looking to dominate the rest of the season, but I do think this will be a relatively close series, but I do not think it will quite go map 5, which is why I do think this one will go 3-1 in favor of the Dallas Empire, crowning them the winners of the Toronto home series and the top team in the game right before CDL championships. All right, guys, well, that's pretty much it for the video here from me today. As I said before, leave a like if you enjoyed, and make sure to subscribe if you're new, and comment below what you thought. I would love to hear your takes on the league in general and this event, and how you think champs may turn out, this event may turn out, all of it. I would love to hear it. But I do plan to return to streaming after this Toronto event concludes, so you guys can look forward to that. I know I am, and I can't wait to talk to you guys again. All right, guys, but that's pretty much all I have for today, and until next time, it has been Chris or CIA. And Dallas, do not disappoint me. Do not disappoint. I'm giving you this last event win right before champs. You guys better come out strong and prove to everyone that I know what I'm talking about at least a little bit. All right, yeah, but that's pretty much it for me. And if you guys enjoy these videos, as always, make sure to let me know so I can continue them. But until next time, it has been Chris or CIA. Peace.